Hi guys, welcome back to another episode of Hala, Atcha. This is our fifth episode, and again, today I'm going to be going over some of the music that I've been listening to recently. Hopefully you guys will enjoy too. So the first song we have up is called Tyler by Coltrane. No, it's not Coltrane, the legendary jazz artist, but it's a new artist. It's spelled C-O-L-3 and then T-R-A-N-E. I chose this song because, well, I really like it because it sort of has this familiar groove that I think everybody will enjoy, but at the same time, he sort of has like a new spin on it, which I think is really good. So, yeah. Garden flex, so in my head did I forget what's wrong? Yeah, yeah, yeah. Sky high on a jet, blowing up while I pretend I'm calm. Yeah. Say I make mistakes too often, and you can't buy them whole problem. But yeah, so that was Tyler by Coltrane, and he's an artist. He's currently in the UK right now. I think he's touring. And he just actually came out with an album, and this is the last song on the album. I think, personally, this is my favorite song so far from him because, again, it sort of has that groove that I think is really good, and the bass behind it, I think, is really, it's addicting. And so, the second song that I want to show you guys is called Loretta by Saint Ivory. And Saint Ivory is a duo. One of the artists actually in the duo is from the show I grew up on. It's called Victorious. It's the person who played Beck, if you guys know who that is. But yeah, so he's a part of this duo called Saint Ivory, and they're making really experimental music, which I think is really good. And it's just, I don't know, it's definitely weird and it's unique, but in a way, I guess that's sort of what keeps bringing me back to them. So yeah, this is Loretta by Saint Ivory.
Loretta, Loretta. You could do so much better than me. You could do so much better than him. You could do so much better than men. I'm glad you're happy. Honestly, you deserve it.
But yeah, that was Loretta by Saint Ivory. And I guess that song sort of has, it reminds me a lot of Frank Ocean's work because the autotune effect on the vocals especially. And I feel like they sort of create the same atmosphere, which I think is really good to listen to. Yeah. And to be honest, I don't know a lot about ATM. I don't know if they're like a group or an individual, but I actually just found this song recently, and it's very hip hop, and I guess it's sort of like not SoundCloud, but it sort of has that sound to it, especially the production behind it with the 808 and everything. But yeah, again, Rush by ATM.
Hey, girl, I get a rush when I'm with you, when I'm with you. Girl, you make me blush when I'm with you, when I'm with you. I even put my phone on hush when I'm with you. I don't need it.
But yeah, that was Rush by ATM. And I think the production behind it is very trap, and you could especially hear it in the drums and everything with the 808s, but there's also like this guitar behind it, and I'm not sure what it is, or it might be a sample of something, but I think, again, that's something else that's really addicting and really, like, good to listen to. So the next song is called Feel Me by Eris Roves. Eris Roves is an artist from the UK currently. I'd say the biggest selling point for him is his voice, because it's definitely unique, while at the same time, it's just easy to listen to, and as soon as you hear it, it's sort of like, I don't know how to describe it. It's just a unique voice that I think is really powerful. So, again, Feel Me, Eris Rove.
My thoughts will always rain on you, yeah. It's a two-way thing. They said that trouble hearts have no vision, but I've seen traces of a love that I can follow like religion. I'm going crazy because I want you, and let me, I don't know.
But yeah, that was Feel Me by Eris Roves. And again, it's another one of those songs that has like a certain groove to it that I think a lot of people would really like. And this man is just talented. There are probably clips of him on the internet performing live. And again, just him and his guitar, his voice is really powerful and it just blends well with everything that he's trying to do here, especially in a song like Feel Me. And so the last song for today is gonna be Why by Amine.
And so this song is actually on his latest album called 1.5. And this is another hip hop song again. And it's very, I guess the reason why I like it especially is the entire album, to be honest, had really good 808s and really good drums behind it. And I think that was the driving force behind the entire album. And just this song in general too, the way that he's able to blend his own melodies also with the drums and everything behind it, I think it just really blends well together. And it sort of creates, it's sort of like his own take on hip hop, where he makes it fun and cheery, but at the same time, it has his own little like dark taste to it, which I really enjoy. Yeah, but again, Why by Mine, and just the 808s and the drums behind that I think are really good and really addicting again. That's another sort of groove thing. I guess that's sort of a common pattern throughout the songs for today's episode. And so yeah, those are 5 songs that I've been listening to recently. I enjoy them. I hope you enjoy them. Thank you guys for watching another episode of Hala Atcha. See you guys next time.